We're going to be looking at simplifying some more radical expressions here. And the ones that we're going to be looking at today really apply this division property of square roots. But anytime you're dealing with radical expressions, there's always some background knowledge that it's good to review. Radical expression, remember, is just simply something under a radical. In this case, and for these examples, our radical is going to be a square root. The radical could be a cubed root or a fourth root, but most commonly it's a square root. And like I said, for this set of examples, we're going to just be using square roots. The number or the expression underneath the square root is called the radicand. And then we have background knowledge of this multiplication property of square roots, where the square root of a times b equals the square root of a times the square root of b. You can separate that square root. And similarly, the division property of square roots takes this quotient of a over b, or a divided by b, and the square root of a divided by b, and splits it into two separate square roots of the square root of a over the square root of b. And remember, whenever we're trying to simplify these radical expressions, we're looking for perfect square factors that we can pull out of the square root. So that basically means we're looking for square numbers. And I have one example that's dealing with variables, and I'll cover that quickly when we get to that. So to start off with, we've got these three examples, and this first example is something that if you run across something like it, you should be happy, because you notice right away that we've got square numbers. Square root of 64 over 25. 64 is a square number, 25 is a square number. So when we use our division property, we write this as the square root of 64 over the square root of 25. And now we can evaluate. The square root of 64 is 8. The square root of 25 is 5. So that simplifies to 8 over 5. Easy enough, because we know the square root of 64 and square root of 25. Getting a little bit more complicated, but I also noticed that I've got a 9 in the denominator here. I know the square root of 9. So when I rewrite this, square root of 30 over square root of 9, I can just simplify the square root of 9 to be 3. And the square root of 30, you have to put a little thought into. Think about the factors of 30. 1 times 30, 2 times 15, 3 times 10. And none of those are perfect square numbers. So you can't simplify the square root of 30 anymore. So we just leave it as the square root of 30 over 3 as that answer. Now, moving on, again, I noticed this 36 in the denominator, and I like that because I know 36 is a square number. 60, I think we'll probably have to simplify a little bit more. So we have the square root of 60 over the square root of 36. I can simplify the square root of 36 into 6. I know that 6 times 6 equals 36. And then the square root of 60, we have to break that down. Remember, we're looking for perfect square numbers. If I think about my factors of 60, I've got 1 times 60, 2 times 30, 3 times 20, 4 times 15. I know that 4 is a perfect square number. So I'm going to stop right there with my factors and use the 4 times 15. Then I use my multiplication property next to split that into the square root of 4 times the square root of 15. That's still all over 6. We know the square root of 4 is 2. Square root of 15, you cannot break that down anymore, so we just leave that as root 15. Write our 6. And finally, we look, can we simplify our fraction, 2 over 6? Those are both even numbers, so 2 goes into itself once, into 6 3 times. So we reduce those, and we end up with 1 times the root 15 is just square root 15. So root 15 over 3 is our final answer for that problem there. Moving on, we get into things that are a little bit more complicated. We end up with the square root of 8 over the square root of 3 applying our division property. And unfortunately, the square root of 3 is not a square number. Our 3 is not a square number, so we can't just simplify that square root easily. Now, the square root of 8 we'll be able to do some things with, but with this square root of 3 in the denominator, that is something that standard form dealing with simplified radicals, we cannot have. We cannot have a square root in the denominator of a fraction. So we have a process that we need to go through, and that process is called rationalizing the denominator. Now, the idea of rationalizing a denominator, the word rationalizing simply means to make the denominator a rational number. So a rational number, remember, means something that can be written as a fraction. In most cases, we're really looking at making it a whole number. So the process that we have to use to rationalize the denominator is to multiply by a factor of 1. Because, you know, if we multiply something by 1, it doesn't change the value. And what we have to do is we have to introduce another square root of 3 into this, because we know that the square root of 3 times the square root of 3 can be simplified. And we'll show that. But if we do it to the bottom of the fraction, we have to do it to the top. Square root of 3 over the square root of 3 is 1, so we're multiplying by a factor of 1. Now let's take a look and see what this looks like then. We end up with the square root of 8 times the square root of 3 on the top. And the square root of 8 can be simplified a little bit more, and I'll do that in a little bit. And on the bottom we have the square root of 3 times the square root of 3. So on the top, the square root of 8, we can write that as 4 times 2, because I know that 4 is a perfect square number. And on the bottom, we have square root of 3 times the square root of 3. We can use our multiplication property to write that as the square root of 9. And you'll notice that I've just created a square number. That is my purpose of multiplying by this same denominator of square root of 3, is I now create a perfect square number, which is 9, and I can simplify that to just be 3. So my denominator is now a rational number. I've rationalized my denominator. And I just have to finish simplifying the top. And the square root of 4 is 2. And we have the square root of 2 left, and the square root of 3 left. And finally, I can just combine my square roots. The square root of 2 times the square root of 3 is the square root of 6. And that is as far as we can go. We have 2 square root of 6 over 3. Now, one of the things that people sometimes try to do to simplify more is they say, well, I've got a 3 and a 6. I can reduce that fraction. You cannot do that because the 6 is trapped inside of that square root. You can only reduce whole numbers and whole numbers. The 6, like I said, is trapped inside that square root. You can't do the reducing until it's outside of the square root. So let's go through another example. Now, with this, I don't see any perfect square numbers with 20 or with 8. So with that, I'm going to divide it first. I see they're both even numbers, so I'm just going to divide those. 20 divided by 8 doesn't come out evenly, but they both have a factor of 2, so that can simplify to 10 over 4. And, you know, 10 over 4 is still got a factor of 2. So I can simplify again, divide by 2 again, and I get 5 over 2. And now I can really start my process of getting my final answer. Split it into two fractions, square root of 5 over the square root of 2. I have to rationalize my denominator because I can't have a square root in the denominator. So I multiply by the square root of 2 and the square root of 2, both numerator and denominator. The top, I end up with just square root of 5 times the square root of 2. I'll just combine those right away to get the square root of 10 because I know I can't simplify the square root of 5. I can't simplify the square root of 2. And on the bottom, we'd end up with the square root of 4 when we take 2 times 2. I'm just going to kind of mentally do this and say the square root of 4 is equal to 2. The square root of 2 times the square root of 2 is just simply 2. And that is my final answer, square root of 10 over 2. Now, you could have gone through and done this problem, rewriting it as square root of 20 over the square root of 8, and then multiply both top and bottom by the square root of 8 to rationalize that denominator. It works out to be the same. There's just a lot more steps at the end for simplifying those square roots, and I'm not going to go through and do them. So if you notice that they're not perfect squares underneath that square root, simplify your fraction if you can first before you go through and work at simplifying your entire radical expression. So we've got one more example, real similar to what we've done, except now we've got variables involved, and that really doesn't change how we do anything, except that we have a variable that we have to deal with. So we first split our fraction up into the square root of 8x to the fifth over square root of 3. Now I need to rationalize my denominator. I will simplify this 8x to the fifth a little bit in a bit, but I need to rationalize my denominator and multiply both top and bottom by the square root of 3. So on the top, I end up with the square root of 8x to the fifth, and I'm going to simplify this now and write 8 as 4 times 2. And I'm going to write the square root of x to the fifth as x to the fourth times x. And I still have my square root of 3 out there. Square root of 3 times the square root of 3, as we showed earlier, comes out to be the square root of 9. Square root of 9 is 3. And now my final steps, square root of 4, I know, is 2. Square root of 2 stays square root of 2. The square root of x to the 4th, whole bunch of things I could say about this. Time-wise, I'm just going to give you the answer. The square root of x to the 4th is x squared. Square root of x just stays the square root of x, and the square root of 3 stays the square root of 3. That's all over 3. And finally, we combine our values that are outside of the square root. So 2 times x squared is 2x squared. And we combine our values that are under the square root. 2 times x times 3, 2 times 3 is 6, and the x just stays the x. So our final answer, 2x squared times the square root of 6x, all over 3. I hope this helps some. Good luck.